Hello, I am Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri, an educationist by profession and an astrologer by passion. Today I'm going to discuss why do some people enjoy using abusive language or while speaking or say gali galoch. I have come across so many who use bad words or gali galoch at the drop of a hat for no rhyme or reason. And all that they have to say is, when I am angry, I am not able to control my tongue. That's not an explanation. Now, let us see what is the possible planet placement in their horoscope or Janmapatri for such a kind of behavior. Why I suddenly thought of this video is, last week I had a client who consulted me who is going through a kind of a rough marriage. And he was checking with me, like while I was studying the chart, I came across this combination. I asked him, like, do you use bad words? Obviously, he won't use it with me or talking to me, right? So he's always polite. So do you use bad words to a near and dear one? So how is the equation and all that? Then he said, ma'am, it's my weakness. I don't know when I get angry. I don't know from where I remember. I remember all the possible of bad words and I use them. Do you do the same thing with your partner? Yes, sometimes. Then I got it and I counseled him. So I thought, why not make a video on this? And, you know, it's very interesting for the students of astrology. Now, this is basically because of notorious planet Rahu. Let us understand some of the salient features of Rahu. Mythologically, you all know the story of Amrita Manthan or Samudra Manthan, right? Rahu is nothing but a severed head of a demon who tried to consume Amrit or the celestial nectar. He has only head because only that drop of Amrit or nectar went and then Vishnu cut off his head. So only head is spinning. That is the mythological aspect. So let us see his characteristics. He has only head, brimming with ideas, all sorts of ideas, and a very active brain. And he is considered as a tamasic planet. Now, Rahu is wicked, crafty, ruthless, and restless. Rahu induces overambition, manipulation, speaking lies, using abusive language when speaking, and creating confusion, amassing wealth by unfair means, getting into corruption when we consider negative traits of Rahu. On the positive note, Rahu, when well placed in a horoscope, induces dissatisfaction. You will try to achieve more and more and try to strive more and more and work harder only when you are dissatisfied with what you have. So that is again Rahu. So he gives a sudden wealth sometimes, like say winning a lottery, then horse racing, betting, share market. The principle of Rahu is, I want to get this by hook or by crook, at whatever cost. That is the quality of Rahu. You know, he doesn't think of dharma, karma, what is right and wrong. Every wrongdoer thinks that whatever he is doing is right. That is the irony of life, actually. So he's also responsible for sudden fame. You know, there are a few actors who nobody has heard about them, but suddenly one fine day, their film just, you know, gets successful and then they reach the pinnacle. We have many such examples in Bollywood and Hollywood. But Rahu, even when he is blessing us, his energy needs to be controlled. Or else you will indulge in extravagance and blow off your wealth by as quickly as you got it by unfair means. So now coming back to the point. When Rahu is placed in the second house, which is called Kutumbasthana or Dhanasthana, or Vanisthana, it is even responsible for your speech. That is a house that represents family, wealth, and the speech of an individual. This is second house from the ascendant or Lagnasthana. The native enjoys speaking lowly and abusive language. I have come across the so-called educated, well-read people speaking like this. Yes, most of them use galis in English, but that doesn't take away the effect, right? So whenever I study the horoscopes, I get into all these kinds of nuances and try to find, and sometimes I ask them point blank, do you enjoy, just like I asked the client last week. So Anyway, when I was addressing, now I'll tell you one very interesting thing. When I was addressing a small group about the placement of Rahu and, in different houses and all that, I was taking a session. One of the participants, when I raised this point, asked me a valid question rather. He was very sincere. Ma'am, do you mean to say that all those who stay in slums and or on streets have Rahu in the second house? Because all of them use bad languages. Well, my answer to this was, actually speaking, you know what, if you are born and raised in such a family and or such a home atmosphere or surroundings where everyone speaks such language, then you may not understand that this is something which should not be done, or this is not to be appreciated, or this is not to be adapted. So you grow up with that. By the time you grow up and you would have become a normal way of life, it would have become a normal way of life for them. They don't even realize that people will mistake us and we can't use this, because everyone, mother, father, everyone uses such language, and even the neighborhood or friends. So such people are there. So you don't have to check the placement. You blame it on their surroundings and the way they have grown up. Because for them, they don't consider it as something very abnormal or unusual. So that was my analysis for them. So guys, check your own horoscope. And if you have this tendency, and also of your friends and relations and all that, verify. Don't believe anything just because I'm saying. You can verify the facts and then trust it. And I don't impose my views on anybody. And this is actually not my finding or anything. This wisdom is from ancient texts of astrology. I came across and I thought of sharing this with you all. So it's up to you all to verify the fact and conclude. And one more thing, this is not only applicable for men, even women. There are women who give a lot of bad talis or bad language they use for their own kids and the younger ones, or while talking with friends and all that, whatever language, whether it's English or any of your mother tongue, it doesn't matter. So ultimately, bad word is a bad word. So try to control such tendencies if you come across. And if you have liked my video, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you get instant notifications. I'm still a student of astrology. I've been studying it for the past 30 years, and for the past 20 plus years, I have been practicing also. I just enjoy whenever I get time. I'm very hungry for knowledge, so I keep on learning something and, practicing. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you, and God bless.